Friday, the 20th of September. Welcome everyone to the program. This is Your Business Morning. We're live to you from Lagos, Nigeria's financial and economic headquarters. Let's get the show started. I am Bosun Omofayo. Welcome our viewers here in Nigeria and around the world. Nigeria's anti-graft agency called the EFCC says it's still pursuing new investigations into allegations that billions of naira of the Paris Club refunds to some state governments have been misused. According to media reports, the states of Delta, Bauchi, Cross River, and Nasarawa are the states which the EFCC says they are focusing on to try and find out what has happened to this nearly 1 trillion naira that the Buhari's administration has refunded the states and state governments and the FCT since December last year to ease the economic crunch in the country. The agency says they're revisiting some of these cases of alleged mismanagement of these billions and billions of naira being shared. But let's get on to the blues all around the concession. This is what the news round looks like. The Minister of State for Aviation, Hadi Sirika, says the Buhari's administration has approved the concession of two other airports, that's in Kano and Port Harcourt, to join Lagos and Abuja, that's previously announced, and that transaction advisors have been cleared begin the process of concessioning now a total of 4 airports, Abuja, Lagos, Port Harcourt, and Kano. The concessions, as you can see, will get underway as Nigeria now pushes for what you call the certification of the airports, which will enable the government get a proper valuation of the assets when they sit down with the new concessionaires around a table and go under a new arrangement. Concession, as we all know, is to put parts of the airports under private sector management, which will include the terminals, of course, where there's a bit of a more commercial part of the airports. The Nigerian government will retain the overarching security around the landing areas, the tarmac, and other parts of the airports. Of these 4 airports will be retained by the government, while the terminals, both the old and the new ones, will be concessioned, including the cargo handling areas of the 4 airports that will now be commercialized by and handed over to companies that will be bid for them. And of course, the process is part of what is causing some disquiet as we speak. On Tuesday, the workers of the Federal Airports Authority of Nigeria under the union staged some protests saying the government must stop this plan to concession the airports. They also want the government agencies to engage the workers and tackle the likely job losses and, of course, consider the existing 64 legal cases allegedly hanging around the concessions already done by the Federal Airports Authority of Nigeria. The workers claimed there are about 64 cases that are still pending in various courts, and until those ones are resolved, including likely job losses, the government, the Buhari's administration, should please keep its hands off those airports in the meantime. Meantime, the government is going ahead by appointing financial advisors to advise the government. Of course, this will go with the Bureau of Public Enterprises and the Ministry of Labor and Productivity, everybody around the table. But the workers, the aviation sector says that they don't want this to happen, at least not anytime soon. And of course, one big story on the street over the last couple of hours is the government's, what's the state of the financials of the Buhari's administration? Reactions is continuing to trail the Statistics Office debt profile of the government, state by state, and the federal government that was released yesterday. That's part of what the NBS released on Tuesday. And since those figures went online, a little bit of reactions on social media on how much rapid borrowings the Buhari's administration has been engaging in nearly 3 years in office. The data currently shows that the Nigerian government, the current administration, borrowings has increased by 40% between 2015 to date, with the government planning more Eurobond and diaspora dollar bonds before the end of 2017. The Debt Management Office Director General, Patience Oniha, was on China's television live on Monday, 3 days ago, and spoke to that. And she said the government is going back to the international debt market for another round of Eurobond and diaspora bond. We had about $300 million diaspora bond already and about $1.5 billion in Eurobond that this administration had borrowed within the last 12 months. Put in total, we have about $2 billion already out there. And those figures exclude the loans from multilateral agencies, which includes the African Development Bank for $600 million that the Buhari's administration got in 2015. All this put together, folks say the government is borrowing too fast. But again, where is the money coming from? So that's the borrowing on one side. Then you have other money coming in from the Inland Revenue Service, which is the FIRS. The head of the agency on Tuesday says a total of 2.5 trillion naira has so far been generated in 2017 between January and August. That's bringing us, giving us 8 months out insight into what's been generated since the year started. That's as far as the January to August was concerned. So oil revenue in terms of, or tax, I beg your pardon, oil tax accounts for about 65% of that total, 2.5 trillion naira. Meantime, how does the money go? The vice president about a week ago says that the federal government and the entire 36 states and the FCT spends roughly 700 billion naira every month on salaries and wages and debt servicing. So if you do a simple math of 700 billion naira every month and you look at the FARC allocations, then you find out that the financials of the Buhari's administration looks a little bit in the water. Of course, that conversation is on social media as well. Everyone is asking how this money is being spent. Of course, the MTEF provides a framework for this administration's borrowing and expenditure all the way until 2019. Let's get into the markets. Now, not so sweet Tuesday trading at the stock market. We finished off down on the counter 0.08. That's 0.1%, a little bit less than that. That's a little bit better than what we started the week with, but the market is still in a sell-off mood. We've forgotten 36,000, haven't we? Of course, we lost 37,000 in the month of August. We lost 36,000. Now we've lost 35,000. Now we're down to 34,846.82 on the composite index reading. In terms of market cap, the stock market has lost about 1.3 trillion naira in less than 2 months. And that's the bad news.